The world is a huge place, with all kinds of people who look, think, and act differently. The categories of honor and shame help us understand world cultures. But what is honor and shame? Remember the pressure in high school to wear certain clothes or talk a certain way to be cool? Honor is when others respect you for observing group expectations, and shame is when people scorn you for being inadequate. Recall Job. He was an esteemed person, but after he lost everything, he lamented, "My friends forgot me. I'm a stench to my own family. Even young children despise me. God has stripped my glory from me." That's shame, when the community rejects you as worthless. And remember, cultures use many words to talk about honor, like glory, face, name, or dignity. Guilt-based cultures in the West appeal to laws and justice to define morality, but shame-based cultures in the East rely upon relationships and reputation to guide behavior. So think of honor and shame as a social credit rating. Since relationships and family are so important, your most valuable asset is your reputation in the community. Avoiding shame and acquiring honor is the operating system behind everyday life in non-Western cultures. That's why honor-shame cultures speak indirectly, to preserve face and harmony. Talking directly can be offensive, so use words to communicate honor, not just ideas. Honor-shame cultures also focus on events, because gatherings confirm group identity. Starting on time without someone means they are not important to the group. Honor-shame cultures are also collectivistic, so what one person does affects the entire community. People get their identity from the group, not individual accomplishment. Finally, honor-shame groups are incredibly hospitable because sharing food together means community and acceptance. If honor and shame are driving forces in most cultures, what does the Bible say about honor and shame? Well, a lot. "Do not fear, for you will not be ashamed. Do not be discouraged, for you will not suffer disgrace. My salvation and my honor depend on God. Everyone who believes in Him will not be put to shame." The Bible is covered in shame and honor because the Bible was written in an honor-shame culture. And many other words communicate honor and shame metaphorically, like Ephesians 2:19. "You are no longer strangers and aliens, but you are fellow citizens with the saints and members of the household of God." Throughout the Bible, when God saves, He rescues from shame and restores honor. After Adam and Eve sinned, they hid and covered themselves because they felt shame. But God set out to reverse human shame by blessing Abraham with a huge family and great name. Then Israel became lowly slaves in Egypt, but God made them a great nation, His treasured possession. Or Ruth and Naomi were destitute widows, but God used Boaz to redeem them from shame by restoring their land and giving a royal son. While David was a young boy herding sheep, God raised him up to be a king with a great name and everlasting throne. Even Jesus was publicly disgraced on the cross, but God exalted him to the heavens, where Jesus sits at God's right hand with a name above all names. Because of Jesus, whoever believes in Him will not be put to shame, but have honor from God. All throughout the Bible, God works to remove shame and restore honor to the human family. So how can we bless people with God's honor? It's easy. First, eliminate shame. All people deal with shame, including you and me. We feel inadequate, deficient, or worthless for not living up to expectations. But the cross covers that false shame. Before we share God's honor with other people, we must receive it ourselves. Second, eating together with other people communicates honor and worth. That is why Jesus feasted with the outcasts. Sharing a meal shows value and forms relationships. So invite people to your house for a meal or accept their invitation. Third, ease conflict. When there's a problem, keep one eye on the issue and your other eye on the relationship. Being too blunt may shame people. So use suggestions or questions to not offend. And when you must reconcile with someone, realize a verbal apology may expose old wounds, but offering a gift or meal can restore relational harmony. Finally, evangelize well. Here's the good news for people feeling shame. God wants to honor you as His child, but our sin dishonors God and brings shame. Fortunately, Jesus took our shame and restores honor. So be loyal to Jesus to enter God's family and receive His name. The world is a big place, but knowing about honor and shame can help us understand and bless all peoples. For ministry resources on honor and shame, visit honorshame.com.